Morning, everyone. This is Terry Kugler from Kugler Landscaping coming at you with another video review of blowers, backpack blowers, and push blowers and ride-on blowers. I'll talk a little bit about them as well. Been in business 41 years, so I'm have used a lot of equipment, and although I am solo, so I don't use as much as some of the big outfits, but I am familiar with most of the equipment because I've been around 41 years. So currently this is the things that I have for the upcoming leaf season, which is just 4, 5, 6 weeks away from kicking off here in Ohio. And we're starting off with the billy goat and push blowers. I used to use the two I've used primarily is Little Wonder and Billy Goat. Back 10, 15 years ago, I switched to Billy Goat. Back in the day, it was more powerful. They'd just come out with it, and it was a lot more powerful than the Little Wonders. I'm sure Little Wonders stepped up their game at this time, but I haven't used one recently. So the good is it's got a 13 horsepower Honda. Love that. I think it's one of the better mowers, motors going. It's fairly lightweight. It's about 150, 60 pounds, somewhere in that neighborhood. I like that it sits up a little higher, seems to blow the leaves, a little bit bigger pile of leaves. It doesn't get up underneath them and not able to push them. So, and the chute's adjustable. So I'll walk you around a little bit. So that knob there, you can adjust the angle so you can scour the ground a little bit more combination. It's got a very big opening. I've cut mine off a little bit. So I think it's around 6 inches thing. Hole there, so it really shoots it out there. Like the handle, it's pretty comfortable, nice foam grip on there. Some of the issues I have, or I think could be improved, are we'll jump back and forth, the good and the bad. Is that bar there is very close to the ground. I would like to see another inch or two of clearance coming up over any regulate things in the yard where you have roots or a little curb or hump or something that gets hung up on it. Also, the pro that it sits up and shoots the chute's a little higher off the ground is good, but at the same point, the motor's up high, the wheelbase isn't very wide. So it's somewhat wobbly on hillsides, and I would say it, I wouldn't say it's real easy, but it's a little tipsy. So I'd like to see that improved, either get the everything a little lower or just maybe widen up the back wheels there 2 to 4 inches would may improve it. You can kind of see. This one's out there, so yeah, I think because it's a lot of motor there and it's the heaviest thing on the unit. So other than that, it's been pretty good over the years for me. So it's my thing, blower of choice. And when I first started 41 years ago, the backpack blowers weren't as powerful. And but nowadays a good backpack blower like the two I have here would be I spend, if I had to have one unit, I would use, you know, I spend most of my time being solo here. I use the backpack blowers. That's something I just couldn't live without. So we'll jump back over them here and touch on them a little bit for a few minutes. I've got a BR800X steel. And I've got the Big Bad Echo PB9010T. And between them two, The echo is clearly more powerful. Not a great deal. I would say 10%-ish. But overall, I'm still, if I was going out and to buy a backpack blower today, I would buy the Steel over the Echo. And the reason being is the straps are slightly more comfortable. The chute, the way it bends, that's this part here, the tubing, much more flexible and comfortable. And so the grip is more comfortable on it in a better position. The housing back here is smoother, so when you're around bushes and taking it off and on things, this part here doesn't get hung up. Where over here you have the carburetors that hanging out, the tanks hanging out. So, I mean, it's a good looking blower, the Echo, but I just think the fit and finish almost on every aspect of the Steel is better. The chute's better, the grip's a little better, the straps are just slightly better. It's kind of a wash there, but the big thing that I noticed is just the comfort of the unit, everything I just spoke about. I can much more easily use the Steel over the Echo, but if all you're basing on is power, then it's certainly more powerful, the Echo. So that's kind of my take on it. So I just like the fit and finish. I think it's more thought through and executed on the Steel. So to me, the Steel's still the king of backpack blowers, or one of them. I'm not a fanboy of any product per se. I'm solo. I don't get paid or sponsored by anybody. I've been doing it 41 years. I just pick a product that works for me. So, and then again, I'm always it's always applicable to what you're doing in properties, and if it works for you, then that's great. So these currently, I like the Billy Goat. One that I'm interested in trying or at some point is the Skag interest me, and I would like to try there. I think I forget what it's called, it's, the Force or something. But anyhow, it's supposed to be even more powerful. It's kind of a cross between the Billy Goat and the Little Wonder. I wonder if it's not made by Little Wonder, because it really looks very similar with a couple additional features. It's supposed to be more powerful than either one of these by a few hundred CFMs, a couple hundred or something. So I'd like to try that. But the Billy Goat, the only thing I've really been a little bit unhappy with is just the stability of it. I'd like to maybe see a little bit bigger tires, again, bigger, taller tires, and a little wider tires just tend to roll a little bit better. So just like to see Billy Goat stabilize the machine a little bit better by lowering the center of gravity, or just a combination of that and a little bit wider footprint on the axles. So kind of that's my take on that. And then again, being solo, I'm doing about I do 15, 20 lawns a week. I'm full service, so I'm at my customers' houses hour, half, 3 hours each week. So that's how I get by with so few customers, and most of them's close to a quarter acre. I've got some in the half acre mark that I take care of, so that's why I select these type of products. If I was at the half acre doing acre, 5 acre lots, certainly I would probably have a stand-on blower, but for a quarter acre lot and even a lot of half-acre lots, I think it's, you know, somewhat overkill. And being solo, you can only use one, you know, unit at a time. If you're running a crew, you can have a guy on the stand on and a couple guys with the backpack blowers and so forth, and which I ran a crew in my younger days, so I'm familiar with that. So it's all getting the product and the right application for your business, and making money at the end of the day, and having being productive. So that's things I speak about. So that, you know, touches back to the backpack blowers. I just find that being more comfortable and ease of use is still the weapon of choice in backpack blowers over the Echo. I just find the weight of the Echo, it's 2 or 3 pounds heavier. The chute is more fatiguing to use, even though supposedly they've softened it up, but I still find it too stiff. And with my longer arms, the cable here is a little short as well. Just like I said, the fit and finish on the Echo, in my opinion, humble opinion, is not, you know, as good as the Echo in most, still in most cases. So that's just my 2 cents, and wanted to share that with you. And so that's the Billy Goat. I've had had different ones. Pardon the cricket, seems to want to chime in here as well. It's in the background, so every time I get started, it's quiet, and when I get going, it's wanting to chirp up, so pardon that. So there we have it, the Echo 9PB90T10T. And the Echo BR800X and the Billy Goat with a 13 horsepower Honda motor. So I believe that's my time. So if you have any questions, or I'm sure I've not touched on everything, and like I said, just shooting this out there, don't have any notes or anything. So that if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them, and I'll either get back with you or make a video, another video about that question you may have. So have a good day, and that's all from Kugler Landscaping, and thanks for watching.